Before we return to Midgard, I should warn you. More time has passed than you likely realize. The snowfall that began when you slew Baldur, it's become something else. The stuff of omens.
Omens for the coming of winter.
Not just any winter. A great winter to span 3 summers. And when it's done, Ragnarok begins.
Ragnarok? From snow?
Aye. Snow. Lots more snow. And then the end of the bloody world, in that approximate order.
Another prophecy.
No, brother. Prophecy doesn't expect this for 100 more winters at least. You've changed something.
I'm telling you, it's Fimbul winter. I can feel it in my throat. This is the big one.
Stop saying that. Oh, you're making me very nervous. It was bound to snow sooner or later.
That ain't just snow, and you know it. It's the end time.
How dare you?
Guys?
Just discussing the weather. Bit of a cold snap lately.
What he means is, Fimbul winter's upon us, boys. The winter to end all winters. I can feel it in my throat.
Yeah. We heard.
So, if you're heading home, try to keep moving. And also, to not die.
Or if you're not heading home, same advice.
Sorry you wasted my time.
Amir, what else did the serpent tell you when you spoke? Kinda sounded important.
I'm sure it's nothing. He just said the boy seemed familiar to him.
Me? That's impossible.
Don't I quite agree? Unless, perhaps, he refers to something yet to be. It is said that when Jormungandr and Thor battle at Ragnarok, their clash so violently shakes the Tree of Life that it splinters, casting the serpent backward through time, even before his own birth.
What?
That is madness.
Well, I did say not to concern yourself.
There's an entire city under the water.
Aye, lad. A forgotten city.
What was it called?
Well, I forgot. Now then, that story I started earlier. Grungnir, the simple-minded stone giant, was invited by Odin to his palace in Asgard. There he gives Grungnir his fill of mead, and goads him into all manner of boasts and antics, all for the amusement of the court. That's there. I saw the Aesir laugh as Hrungnir leapt upon his shield and swore he'd kill us all and take our womenfolk back to Jotunheim. Does he laugh? Oh, no. Or I can just tell you this story later.
Look here.
It says, glory to Mozigir, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome. I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break. Oh, what brings you around, friends? Well, when you do need something, I'll be around.
Whoa. Look, a dragon. But it's chained. Is it a pet?
Do not get any ideas.
can't believe the chain is the only thing holding him down.
Odds are there's a bit of magic at play here as well. This is a dwarven stronghold, after all.
That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
want for?
Stone number two. This place is even bigger than Vaedergard.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
Wonder what happened to him.
'Tis a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mozognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic.
Why?
The Dvegrath Eaker, the very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness.
Huh!
of them? Set me free.
Yeah.
There he is. Or she is? Are these boy or girl dragons?
No. There are a few ways to find out, but they're rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
Trying to feed it.
ready!
Seems like the right thing to do.
Atreus, follow me. Look here.
Yes, sir. Another marker.
Amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well, what can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble. Rarely does it pay off.
If you say so.
Here we go!
Huh. It's kinda run down in here.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruined, I guess? Maybe the throne room's in better shape. Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. Large crowd of people.
Just old spirits, I suppose. Leftover victims of the Mad Dwarf's reign. Still, that's rather ominous.
Another one here.
Stargather. Wow, that's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
Six, seven, eight? Could he shoot four bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the two eyes.
It looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Getting louder. They sound almost like
Hellwalkers.
I felt that one, brother.
Ugh!
Where's the passage behind this throne?
A secret passage!
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Boy.
Wonder who wrote this. The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. He once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
This place looked like in better times.
Conan's Gard was a beautiful land in its heyday, before the Dwarf King's obsession poisoned his mind.
How could he let that happen?
The dwarf blindly trusted in the legend and pursued it without thought to the consequences. This is the result.
Trust is a gamble, like you said, and the Dwarf King lost.
Ah!
Found the legendary materials? Incredible! Oh, this is so exciting! Meet me back at the temple and we'll get started right away! Let's do it! I suppose you prefer my brother's work? You're wrong, of course.
Why is Odin so desperate to find a way into Jotunheim anyway?
He's convinced the giants hold the key to changing his fate when Ragnarok comes. They are the Aesir's oldest enemies, after all, and it's their army that's supposed to do him in the end. But more than that, he covets their gifts of prophecy. He wants to know what they know and see what they see. So much suffering could have been avoided if his insatiable curiosity was not so much stronger than his wisdom.
What do you mean?
Ah, remind me to tell you why they call him the Lord of the Hanged.
Whoa.
You boys look right, Beam.
They found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so... so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
None your fucking business. Trade secret.
We get our ways.
Oh.
Sure, I'm open.
Another time, then.